Nowadays it's rather nobby to regard one's private hobby as the object of one's tenderest affections.
Some excel at alpine climbing, others have a turn for rhyming, while a lot of people go in for collections.
Quite right. Such as fancy Grecian vases or exquisite Irish laces.
Jacobean soup tureens, early types of limousines.
First edition, still uncut.
Daily pranks of Jeff and Mutt.
But my favorite pastime is collecting country places. I've a shooting box in Scotland.
How may I be your guest?
I've a chateau in Touraine.
Wine country, I love it.
I have a silly little chalet.
Where's this?
In the Interlochen Valley.
Uh-huh.
I have a hacienda in Spain.
Ole, bravo! I have a private fjord in Norway. I have a villa close to Rome.
And in traveling, it's really quite a comfort to know that you're never far from home.
Now I have a bungalow at Simla.
Oh, have you?
I have an island way out east of Maine. If you care for hotter places, I have an African oasis on an uninhabited plain.
I have a houseboat on the Yangtze.
Chop.
I have an igloo up at Nome.
Rather brisk there.
Yes, in traveling, it's really quite a comfort to know
that you're never far from home.
Oh, and I've a pyramid in Egypt.
Oh, they're very common there.
And a sailboat on the Nile.
The winds must be chancy. There's a beach, you know, in fair Tahiti. I obtained by special treaty, and I've got a small hotel, keep this quiet, in Carlisle.
Oh, that must be exciting. I've a stately home in Moscow.
Near the Kremlin?
Yes, with a spire and a dome. So no matter where I chance to be, it's lovely to know
that I'm never far from home. In collecting all these homesteads, we just never seem to cease. From our holdings in Alaska to the Bay of Madagascar
and apartment buildings in Greece.
Now if you really want to reach us, if you have some work we can do, we have a tidy little lean-to underneath the bridge, just a fairly shabby shack,
and the plumbing's out in back.
You would bring that up.
I'm sorry.
And so we're never far. Oh, no, we're never far. Oh, no, we're never, never very far from home.
How about a bit of backgammon, old boy?
Backgammon?
Rubber of tennis?
No, I tell you, I think what we should do, you put on the glasses, get the cup and the cane, I'll take the arm out of the sleeve, and we'll go hit a few bus stops and see if we can pick up some dinner money. Come along now.
Rather.
Cheer-o.
Right, sure.
Here we go.